Let's be honest. Almost every country in this world is influenced by the United States in one way or another. For example, in Japan, a hot dog is called hotu dogu, and a corn dog is called an American dogu. Meanwhile, in France, brass knuckles are called American fists. With this being said, how do you think a kind of American town in Brazil is called? Well, if you said American no dogu or Brazilian fists, you're wrong, because the Confederates who came to this town in 1866 weren't so creative, so they just called it Americana. However, you could have just gotten so caught up in this dogu stuff and didn't realize I've just said that there's an American town in Brazil, so pay attention. Now, you're probably wondering, how did Americana become an American town in South America? Good question. Let me explain. After the American Civil War, slavery was abolished all over the United States because the Confederacy, which were these guys, lost against the Union, which were these guys. So, fortunately for the Union and an entire race, slavery was gone. But some dudes in the South were upset because now they couldn't be making as much money. The South had an economy based on agriculture that relied heavily on slave-worked plantations. But when slavery wasn't a thing anymore in the United States, many Confederates chose to leave the US, and most of them went to, surprisingly, Canada. No, I'm just kidding. They went south. Yes, the Southerners just went more south. Some historians estimate that between 20 and 40,000 American Southerners arrived in Brazil in the 10 years following the Civil War. But why there? Why didn't they go to Colombia? Or Chile? Well, because Brazil was one of the last countries in the Americas to outlaw slavery in 1888. Yeah, some of them went to other Central or South American countries to try and form Confederate colonies. But most Southerners arrived in a nice place 68 miles out of Sao Paulo, which was called the Village of the Americans. Later in 1938, it was named Americana by the mayor. So, sorry for lying and telling you previously in the video that the Confederates named the city Americana when they arrived, but the story sounded better. So, the Confederates arrived in Brazil because slavery was still legal and they needed enslaved people to grow crops. The emperor of the Brazilian Empire at that time was this man with the beautiful long beard. No, not this guy, this dude, Dom Pedro II. He was an ally to the Confederacy during the Civil War. Also, he wanted US Confederates to come because Brazil had been trying for years to match North American and European agricultural development. So, when Southerners wanted to immigrate, he saw an opportunity to bring the American prosperity to Brazil. He gave cheap land to the Americans and greeted them with open arms. Nowadays, Americana is one of the safest and most developed places in Brazil, so smart guy Dom Pedro. As time passed, Americans realized that the Brazilian soil wasn't so good for growing cotton. But it was optimal for growing other crops, like oranges, sugarcane, and coffee. Some couldn't adapt to the Brazilian economy, so many returned back home into the United States. As years passed, although many left, still a lot of Southerners remained in Americana. Even today, although the Americans got mixed with the Brazilians over the 150 years, you can still see the American influence over the town of Americana. You can see rocking chairs, some residents speak English with a Southern accent, and people still make sweet potato pie. But if you think that's it and people just have English surnames, for example, Fernando Smith, well, you're very wrong, because there's a whole town party or festival or whatever you want to call it, named Festa Confederada. Pictures and videos from here seem to be from south of the Mason-Dixon line in the year of 1850, not from south of the equator in 2020. It's a gathering where the town celebrates the US Confederacy. People wave the flag of the Confederacy, dance, and overall feel good. Anyone can join the party, drink some beer, and then drink some more beer for the Confederados, who were the first settlers who created Americana. Then, after you drank some more beer, you could go see the monument in the memory of the Confederados and pay some respects to their cemetery. Now, you might think that this party's inappropriate because, well, they basically celebrate the US Confederacy, which back in the 1800s thought that slavery was a good thing. Obviously, slavery's awful, but by celebrating the Confederacy, don't these people seem racist? Well, if you were to do this in the United States, you would probably get a lot of hate. But in Americana, as they say, it's not about race. None of them hate anyone, none of them have intentions of insulting anyone, but they say they embrace the culture. They have no racist ideal connected to the flag. It's just a symbol of honor of how it was used in the past. The people of Americana just want to be a part of the history of the Confederacy, because some of them have American blood. Overall, it's a great party that's usually held in April, which reminds us of a nation which has been gone for over a century and a half. But Americana, culturally, might be the last US Confederate town in the entire world.